Okay, this video today is about how to create a Chrome X version 78 live USB with persistent. This is the Ixtone 190824. This is a Chrome OS build. So in this case here, just gonna okay, so so this case here, right now we can find on the web there is the Chromium OS build. There is the Feed OS. There is the Neverware Cloud Ready. There is the Bats, after the Bats built, and now this is Chrome and the Chrome X. So this video, I have a playlist on YouTube about the Chromium OS here. So if you want to try, if you want to learn more about Chromium OS, I have lots of videos about Chromium OS, Feed OS. I don't know if I pronounced the name right here. Feed OS. So anyway, this video is about the Chrome X here. So with the Chrome X is Chrome X is Chromium OS built by the builds from Ixton. I don't know how to pronounce the name. So this is the latest one. You can install Spotify, Gimp using the Flatpak here, App Store. But also you can use the GNOME Software Center. So in this case here, if you want to download, so you don't need to install. So I'm gonna create a live USB here that you don't need to install it to your computer. So I'm gonna use SourceForge here. The files so we're going to download from SourceForge here. So what we're going to do, we're going to save this page here, this is the MD5. So on the downloads folder here, we're going to create a folder with the name Chrome X, and create the folder, and I'm going to save the MD5 here. Also, we're going to download the file is this one here. I want to use different server, so I'm gonna use Silicon Valley web hosting. So we're going to save it to the folder we created here. The four This is a file with the size of 727 megabytes. After you unzip it, it's gonna be like around, I believe, 4 gigabytes and something. With the Arnold the Bat build, it's around 9 gigabytes. Or Chrome OS 9 gigabytes. I have to see the size. So I'm gonna wait until we finish download here. Okay, the download is complete. I'm gonna close this. So now what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna open the downloads folder here. And then what we're going to do here, we're going to verify the ISO, make sure it's the image, make sure it's the right one here. So we're going to use the MD5 here. It has to match these numbers here. So what you're gonna do here, right click on the zip file, click on rename, then you're gonna select the whole thing, right click, select copy, then on the empty space here you right click, select open in terminal. So you have to match the numbers here, 3A here. So we're going to use the command MD5 sum. Then you right click, paste the name of the file, press enter. As you can see, start with 3A, FCA, ends with 32DC. So that means the file is good. So now what we're gonna do now, we're gonna unzip the file. We're gonna unzip the file. We're gonna use Etcher to create the live USB. And I'm going to use a software called Departed to resize the partition, make it to use the whole USB flash drive or hard drive, whatever you want to use. It works. This guide works with a USB flash drive, 16 gigabyte plus, internal or external hard drive, SSD, HDD, micro SD using the USB adapter, but in this case I'm going to use the 16 gigabyte USB flash drive here. I recommend to use SanDisk. This SanDisk here right at the 100 megabyte per second, so it's a very fast USB flash drive. This is a USB 3.0, so you can buy a 3.0, 3.1, 3.2. This is the fastest one. So what we're gonna do here? First, we're gonna unzip the file first. Right click, select extract here. And then I'm gonna download Etcher. So we're gonna click download here. I'm gonna save on downloads. I'm gonna create a folder here called software. I'm gonna click save. So okay, as you can see, it created an image here with the size of 4.7 gigabytes. So the Etcher is downloads here. The Etcher, to install it, you have to unzip it, right click, start here. Just have to do now is double click. So what we're gonna do now, I'm gonna plug in my USB flash drive. So I'm gonna use I recommend use USB 3.0. The faster the USB flash drive is, the better. It will work with USB 2.0 too, but 3.0 is much better. So I recommend to, I'm using a 16 GB, but I recommend to get like a 128. The flash drives get very cheap. So I'm going to select, click here, select image, go to downloads, Chrome X, and the image here, 4.7 GB, click open, so then select the SanDisk here, click on flash. Type your password. Okay, yeah. Now, what I have to do now is close, is complete the flashing. So I'm gonna close the etcher. And I'm gonna, now I'm gonna use a software to resize the partition of the USB flash drive, so you have more space, the whole space for storage in USB flash drive. So we're gonna open the terminal here. So we're gonna install gparted sudo apt install gparted Okay, now we just have to do is departed here. I'm gonna add to the panel here. Also, I have etcher. Let's see where is the etcher here. Just have to double click now. So we're gonna open the chip part in here. Copy your username and password. I mean your password. Click here on fix. So you're gonna select the flash drive here. In my case, it's a 16 GB, so it's a SDB here. As you can see here, we have all this space here. We have 10 GB free space here. So what we're gonna do here, the state partition is where you save all your files, your pictures, your videos, your games, everything. So we're gonna resize that. So we're gonna right click the state, click resize, move. Then what we're gonna do, we're gonna move to use all the space now. Click resize, move. Click apply here. Click apply. I'm gonna close this now. As you can see here, you can boot this drive with legacy BIOS and the EFI, so works on both with old computers with legacy BIOS and with new computers with UFI. So as you can see here, the state partition has 12 GB space here. So when I boot up the computer after the update, all the files, it's gonna sync all the files that are all the software that I have installed on Chrome OS Whereas thinking I'm gonna have almost 10 gigabytes free on this 16 gigabyte USB flash drive. So you can do this. You can do this guide here on USB flash drive, on USB hard drive, USB SSD, SD, micro SD card with a USB adapter. You can use Chrome OS, not only Chrome OS, Chromium OS, but Chrome OS and other GNU/Linux distros on the devices. So I use it as a live USB. So I'm gonna open software here so you can see. So this is the drive here. That's the state partition here. So I have 13 gigabyte free. As you can see here is a Chrome OS firmware here. So my next video is going to be, this guide works on Windows. You can flash the image, use the Etcher works on Windows, Mac OS X. You can use VirtualBox and use Linux Mint Live USB. And you can resize the partition using the Linux Mint Live USB or other GNU/Linux. The next video I'm gonna show a video how to after installation guide of Chrome X. I'm gonna show how to install, how to enable the Linux apps, and I'm gonna install the GNOME Software Center, the GNOME Store, and also the Flatpak. And I want to show how to install Linux apps on Chromium OS. So if you like this video, please subscribe, give a like, and share. And I'll see you in the next video.